Welcome back. In this video, we're going to take a look at actually importing in our image planes and getting them aligned properly. Now, the process itself requires us to, as I said earlier, import these in as a process of referencing. We're going to physically attach these to our cameras in our four-panel view. We can access these cameras by either hitting spacebar or by using the option in the toolbox, which will bring up our top, front, and side. Now, when accessing these views, it's important to choose which image plane to import first. And I'm going to refer to this as my master image. It's going to be the image that's going to tell me the most about my general proportions of the entire aircraft. From project to project, you might have a different master image. In fact, one of the images that I'm going to choose for this project is going to be my top image. And you can see why if we take a look at each of these individual images. My front tells me, I think, a good deal about the sort of width of the aircraft, but not a lot about the depth. The side does tell me a lot about the depth, but really doesn't help me out with these wings. However, the top, I think, gives me a very nice view of what's going on and a sort of easy to rationalize top-down sort of floor plan of this aircraft, which for me, cognitively, seems like it makes the most sense to choose as a master view. Compare this, however, to if I was working on a character. Taking the top view of someone's head and choosing that as a master view might not make a lot of sense. So it's going to be different from project to project what you choose as your master view. Well, I'll go back here into Maya, and I'm going to jump into my top camera and hit spacebar when I'm in that top view. I'll zoom out just a little bit. To import in the top image plane, in the viewport, I'm going to go to View, Image Plane, and choose Import Image. Since I've already set up my project, Maya is smart enough to know to look exactly in the folder that I stored my images in. It knows to look in a Source Images folder for these image planes so that I can find these directly. Since I conveniently named my image planes according to the camera views that I was going to use, the top view is easily selectable. And I hit open. And if I zoom out just a little bit, you'll notice that my image plane has been inserted into this top camera. If I hit spacebar and jump back to the perspective view, notice that I now have, I think, a pretty readily identifiable aircraft right here in 3D. Well, there are some problems with it that I can see. One of them, which hopefully you can view right here, is that the airplane isn't exactly aligned along the center of the grid. And that's one of the first things I want to establish as I put this image plane into its proper place. To do that, however, notice that in the top view, I really can't see the grid on top of the aircraft. And that's because the airplane is actually sitting right on top of this grid right now. So what I want to do is I want to push it away from us, into the screen. I want to push it in a downward direction. Now, one of the things about image planes is that they can be selected in the perspective view. But for your own benefit, they can't actually be selected in the orthographic cameras. And that's going to make it really easy for us to work on this later on. But if you've somehow deselected your image plane, just note that you can always select it in the perspective view, or you can always go to your camera to which it's attached and go to View, Image Plane Attributes, and choose the named image plane, which in this case is Image Plane 1. And that will select it. In this case, it's also going to open up the attribute editor for me, which we're going to keep open because this is going to allow us to alter the position of our image plane. One of the other, I guess, sort of less cool things about image planes, which some people do find kind of annoying, is the fact that you can't just use the Move tool and move this around. It doesn't work like that. What benefit it does have, though, is that it allows you, no matter what view you're in, wireframe, smooth shaded, or textured view, to always see the image. If you just load a texture onto a polygon plane and try and get the same thing, you're always going to have to keep your computer in the 6 mode, the textured mode, and you're never going to be able to trace your wireframe on top of the airplane. Additionally, it's going to be chugging extra memory, keeping all of your models textured at the same time. And this doesn't do that. This is optimized for use inside Maya. So another reason why you should make sure you're using actual image plugins. Well, in the attribute editor, I'm going to scroll down past image plane attributes, past placement, into the section called placement extras. Now here I'm going to have several values at the bottom. Center, X, Y, and Z, a width and a height value. Now we don't need to change the width and the height for this image because we're pretty much going to keep all of our other images proportional to this one. So we're going to eventually change the other images. But we're going to have to make sure we change the center in the left, right, up, down, and forward and backward position. Well, first things first, I want to actually see what happens since my center in the X and the Z has not been set to a value of 0. I'm wondering what happens if I just hit 0 in these two boxes and hit enter. Perhaps this is going to make it more correct. And it might actually have gotten it very, very close. So that's always a pretty good first step. Well, let's see what happens if I change the orientation in the y-axis. Now remember, I want to push this down so it's below the ground plane, just so it doesn't interfere with that grid. So since the y-axis points x, y, and since the y-axis points up and down, and this center box is alphabetical, going x, y, and z, in the center box, the y-axis, let me just type a negative number here, such as negative 20, and I'll hit enter. And you're going to notice that's going to move my image plane down beneath that grid. Let's jump back into my top view by hitting spacebar and see what happens. You can notice by the position of the back of this aircraft that it is close to that center line, but it's not completely accurate. So what I need to do is I need to nudge this airplane to the right just a little bit. And this is all guess and check to get this working. Well, since my axes of orientation tell me which way I'm looking at, it looks like, according to my gizmo in the lower left corner, that the x-axis points to the left and right. And that positive x is going to indicate a direction to the right. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at moving this to the right just a little bit. The x-axis is my first box, again, because this is alphabetically. And if I want to make this move in a positive direction, well, I'll just type a positive number. Let's start with something simple like 1. So I'll type 1 and hit enter and see what happens. Now here's my center line where the cursor is. That value of 1 looks like it was too far. So let's try a smaller value, like 0.1. And that's not enough now. So again, we keep guessing and checking. Let's try 0.2. And it looks like a value of 0.2 is going to be exactly where we need this to be. So what we have is one image plane set up, and we need to bring our other two image planes in and match them to this. The next video is going to cover bringing these other image planes in and getting them aligned to this image plane that we have set up currently. Hold on just a minute. We'll be on video number 4 in just a second.